हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम मिसेस गीता झुंझलवाड़, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ह्यूमैनिटीज एंड साइंसेस, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर। टुडे इन माय सेशन आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट वर्ड फॉर्मेशन मैकेनिज्म इन इंग्लिश ग्रामर। फॉर द सेक ऑफ कन्वीनियंस आई हैव क्रिएटेड दीज पार्ट्स। वर्ड फॉर्मेशन mechanism is the necessity of teaching and learning process. So in this session we are going to discuss about this mechanism in English grammar. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, student will be able to understand word formation mechanism effectively. Now in this session, today we are going to discuss about the definition of word formation, need for word formation in English grammar, processes or the mechanisms, and some of the word formation processes. Now let us discuss about the definition. In linguistics, word formation refers to the ways in which the new words are formed on the basis of other words or morphemes. Alexander Peterson and his colleagues in their report concludes that just as a new species can be born into an environment, a word can emerge in a language. Now see the importance of an academic study. In the Cambridge Encyclopedia of the English Language, David Crystal writes about verb formations. He has said, most English vocabulary arises by making new lexemes out of old ones, either by adding an affix to previously existing forms, altering their word class, or combining them to produce compounds. So let us first discuss what is the need of word formation in English grammar. Take a pause, think about this question and try to give the answer. So let us see the need for word formation. Language is a social fact, a kind of social contact or a system of communication consisting of sounds, words or grammar. Vocabulary is the most important component of any language. For this reason, we must admit that the processes of word formation through which every language vocabulary can enrich are important in English language teaching and learning. Now let us see the processes of word formation. There are number of word formation processes which help producing new words according to the current requirements of the users. Now see the types of word formation. Here are some of the word formation types. The first one is coinage, the second one borrowing, third one compounding, fourth one clipping, fifth one blending, sixth one derivation, and the seventh one back formation. All these types we are discussing during this word formation mechanism. Now let us see the first type of word formation, coinage. Coinage is the word formation process in which a new word is created either deliberately or accidentally without using the other word formation processes. And the sources of coinage words are The first source is commercial products, and the examples are aspirin, Xerox, Kodak, jeans. The second source is words based on the names of persons, and examples are VAT, boycott, Fahrenheit. All these names are some of the famous persons' name. For example, James Watt. The second type is borrowing. English language has been borrowing words from nearly 100 languages in the last 100 years, and even the other languages also borrowing words from English. And examples are, the first example, piano. So this word, actually it is not an English word, it is taken from Italian language. Next one is sofa. Sofa, this word is borrowed from Arabian language. The next example is tattoo. Tattoo, it is a Tahitian language word. This word is borrowed from Tahitian language. Agenda, AM and PM, sponsor, memorandum, all these words are taken, or all these words are borrowed from Latin language. Then pneumonia, panorama, psychology, python, all these words are borrowed from Greek language. Cafe and bureau, these words are borrowed from French language. Now let us discuss about some of the types of borrowing. So these are the two types, loan words and loan translation. So let us see first loan words. A loan word is a term taken from another language and used without translation. Sometimes the word's spelling or pronunciation, or sometimes both, is slightly altered to accommodate English or orthography. But in most cases, it is preserved in its original language. Now let us see loan translation. A loan translation, which is also known as a calque, on the other hand, is a word or phrase taken from another language, but translated either in part or in whole to corresponding English words while still retaining the original meaning. And example is skyscraper. It is a good example of this type of loan translation. French term great ciel, which is literally translates as skyscraper. The next type is compounding. One very productive way that new words are derived in English is by compounding, that is combining two free morphemes to create a new word. Compounding is different from affixation. It derives a new word by joining two different words. In linguistics, compounding means a word that consists of more than one stem. When two words are used together to yield a new meaning, a compounding is formed. And examples are footpath, which is composed of two nouns, foot and path. The next example is blackbird. It is a combination of black and bird. These are the two separate nouns, and this word is a combination of these two words. English compound words are stressed on their first component word. And example is footpath. So in this compounding word, the stress is on the first component word, that is footpath or blackbird. So here on these examples, we can see that the stress is on the first syllable or on the first component word. So types of compounding. Compounding can be categorized as endocentric and extrocentric. Most English compound nouns are endocentric. This means that the central meaning of the compound is carried by the head. An example is blackboard. With extrocentric compounds, however, the central meaning of the compound is not conveyed by the head. And examples are pickpocket, show off. But sometimes more than two words can form a compound. And example is mother-in-law. This is a book which I have used to make my PPT. So go through the reference. Thank you.